Jim, playoff positioning at stake here in Houston today as the Colts take on the Texans. Hi, everybody. Welcome to Reliance Stadium. Ian Eagle along with Solomon Wilcox. Scenario is pretty simple for Indianapolis. A win here, they will be the number three seed in the AFC. They'll have a home playoff game next week. A loss could drop to number six. Let's take a look at your Chevrolet keys to the game today.
Well, for the Houston Texans, their offense really is their best defense. They have to be able to sustain drives and keep Indianapolis offense on the sideline. And the Colts defense, well, they got to show up today because their inability to stop the run makes them a less than dominant football team. And Peyton Manning, well, for him, the more the merrier. Only 37 offensive snaps last week. He needs the ball more today. More opportunities will present more big plays.
All the action is coming up from the site of Super Bowl 38 here on CBS, Houston, Texas.
Start your New Year's celebration early. The Minnesota Gophers go head-to-head with the Oregon Ducks. The Wells Fargo Sun Bowl, Wednesday on CBS.
The King of Queens, Catch It, Wednesdays on CBS. It's all here.
There are plenty of reasons why Ford SUVs are the best in Texas. And one reason, now's the time to save plenty on them. It's year-end clearance at your Texas Ford dealer. Now through the 31st, get the best deals on the best-selling SUVs, including Ford Explorer. Get great low-clearance financing, as low as 0% for 72 months. Get up to $4,000 cash on Explorer. Put $1,000 down, and Ford Credit will match it for a total $6,000 down payment. Don't miss year-end clearance at your Texas Ford dealer.
The Lexus December to Remember sales event. You'll find incredible values whether you buy or lease. Missing it would definitely spoil the surprise. See your Houston area Lexus dealer.
It's 10 o'clock. Do you know which newscast to watch? Is it the one that's on or the one that's on over here on Channel 11? Over here, we've put together a newscast with the city's best reporters and most ambitious news franchises. A 10 o'clock newscast designed to be the best half hour of local news on television. Informative, upbeat, original. Want a wrap up that never lets you down? You want 11 News at 10, because we go there.
Tents, backpacks, sleeping bag. I think that's everything.
Yeah.
What are you doing?
Can't wait for yours? Only a few days left in the Jeep year-end sales drive to get $500 in holiday bonus cash. Now for a limited time, get 0% financing plus $500 bonus cash or a $4,000 total cash allowance on Jeep Grand Cherokee. Act now. Bonus cash offer ends soon.
35 days.
It's a Super Bowl
on Channel 11.
Sports, home of Super Bowl 38.
From Reliance Stadium, Peyton Manning and the Colts try to secure the AFC South title. We'll have the kickoff next.
Subway presents Fresh Starts, a glance at teams looking to turn heads this season. Subway, eat fresh.
Keep fighting, keep fighting.
Last Sunday, the Broncos fought to their fourth straight win. Denver rushed for 227 yards, 136 coming from rookie Quentin Griffin in place of an injured Clinton Portis. Quarterback Jake Plummer scored two rushing touchdowns as Denver defied doubters and clinched a postseason berth.
Introducing Subway's new Atkins-friendly wraps, like the savory chicken bacon ranch wrap and the turkey and bacon melt wrap. Packed with all the delicious taste you'd expect from Subway, but with under 11 net carbs. They'll help you satisfy your low-carb goals. As for your other goals, like avoiding your in-laws indefinitely, well, there you're on your own. The new Atkins Friendly Wraps from Subway. Good, so you don't always have to be.
Back to throw is Manning again. Wide open, touchdown. Dumps it up in the end zone. Touchdown!
Manning dropping. Manning pressure. Caught. Touchdown, Indianapolis Colts.
Manning out of a shotgun.
Touchdown! Sets up. Touchdown! I think they got it. They're going to win. And a month from now, the Indianapolis Colts are hoping to book their flights to Houston, Texas, the site of Super Bowl 38. Just about ready for kickoff. Before we do that, let's send it downstairs. Third member of our broadcast team, Hall of Famer Marcus Allen.
Thanks, Ian. We always talk about teams speaking at the right time. Well, players speak at the right time, too. Edgerrin James for the Colts is finally returning to top form from that devastating knee injury 2 years ago. He's starting to have that explosiveness again, guys. And I talked to Tony Dungy. He said it's the freshest he's seen Edgerrin. And that's dangerous for any opponent, guys. Back up there.
That's a good point. And Solomon, he missed three games earlier in the season with that back injury. And maybe that body is a little bit fresher in December.
Yeah, they're using him less as a receiver. You know, normally they would line him out wide and try to throw him the ball. And he would run into the defense on slant routes. But now they're exclusively using him out of the backfield and using other running backs to catch the ball.
Indianapolis coming off an embarrassing loss to Denver, 31-17. They've won the toss. And Houston will kick it off with Chris Brown. Dominique Rhodes, the deep man for Indy, standing at his own goal line. Colts 11-4, Texans second year of existence 5-10. Regular season finale from Houston. Brown on the kickoff, and here's Rhodes returning. Dominique Rhodes looking for a lane, gets through a hole, cuts it back at the midfield area and cuts into Houston territory before DeMarcus Fagans brings him down. Strong return by Dominique Rhodes, 49 yards to get this one started. Offensively for Indianapolis, Peyton Manning is coming off his worst game of the season. 12 for 23, 146 yards last week in that loss to Denver at the RCA Dome. Offensive line, Jeff Saturday has been in there. 16 starts this season for Indy. A three-receiver set as we look at the skill position players, and Marvin Harrison, 8 receptions shy of his fifth straight 100-catch season. First and 10, 49-yard line of Houston to open up. Manning on the give to James, a stiff arm. And James smacked down at midfield by Kylie Wong. Some help from Jay Foreman, a loss of one. Defensively for the Texans, so many injuries that they've dealt with this year. Jerry DeLoach has been the mainstay on that defensive line in the 3-4 set. Linebackers, Jamie Sharper leading the NFL in tackles. He's got 180 entering action. And DeMarcus Fagans making his first start at corner. Injuries to Aaron Glenn and Kenny Wright. On a second and 11 for the Colts. Manning straight back. Quick throw. It's Pollard, the tight end. Drives forward to the 40-yard line. A little bit shy of a first down as Marcus Coleman took that hit. It's a 10-yard gain.
And I had Tony Dungy told us, he said, we're going to give him some three wide receiver sets. We're going to go no huddle. He doesn't want Dom Capers to come with the 3 and 4 defensive back packages. So he wants to be able to keep his receivers out there and feel like he gets a more favorable matchup with his three wide receiver set.
Third and one right now for Indianapolis. You see what they've done on third downs this season, nearly 42%, top 10 in the National Football League. Out of the shotgun, Manning. Manning steps forward and zings one back. Incomplete. Marvin Harrison matched up with Fagans. And Indianapolis is unable to convert.
Well, watch the coverage by Fagans because he does an excellent job in coverage, matched up against Harrison in the slot. Now watch him undercut this route. See, when he comes underneath, it puts him in a tremendous position to intercept the pass. This young player, you know, we have heard a lot about him coming in. He's getting his first start this week. But I see why Dom Capers decided to go with Fagans, because he has good footwork and great anticipation.
And the Colts do nothing with tremendous field position set up by the return by Dominique Rhodes. Now, J.J. Moses, the punt returner for Houston, And Hunter Smith standing at his own 45. High punt sailing over the head of Moses. It'll take a bounce into the end zone and a touchback. 40-yard punt, a net of just 20. And David Carr, in his second season, Carr has been held back this year because of an ankle sprain and a sprained throwing shoulder, but there has been progress in his play in year two. Take a look at the offensive line. They got crushed a year ago. They've been better this year. Fred Worry stepping in for Zach Wiegert, who is active but nursing an injury to his elbow. Backs and receivers. Andre Johnson, chance to go over 1,000 yards in his rookie year out of Miami. Dominic Davis, the running back as well, can crack 1,000. Davis gets the call. Spun around on first down, and he picks up a yard, yard and a half. Just about everybody involved for Indianapolis. Their defense comes in ranked number 12. They were as high as number 8 in recent weeks under the tutelage of Tony Dungy. Up the middle, Larry Triplett, a big body for this Colts defensive line. Linebackers, Rob Morris, a concussion last week against Denver, but he's in there as the starter. And in the secondary, injury to Mike Doss. Donald Strickland gets the nod. On the give, Davis trying to push the pile, keeps the legs churning, and he gains 3 on second down. Morris involved in the stop for Indianapolis.
Well, you mentioned the leg drive of Dominic Davis. That's the reason why he leads all rookie running backs in rushing so far this year, looking to go over 1,000 yards this season. But his ability to sustain that leg drive, that's what allows him to break tackles. He's not a big guy, but he's low to the ground. He runs with greater power than what his body weight would suggest.
Davis told us his goal was just to make a team in the NFL. He wasn't even thinking about starting. He got the nod week 6 for Houston this year, a 3rd and 6. 4 receivers set. Carr sets up. Carr, a pump fake. Throw. Level. They rule it incomplete. Derek Armstrong getting smacked just shy of the marker in his first year from Arkansas Monticello.
Yeah, Armstrong will take a whack. And this is what Tony Dungy wanted. He wanted to see his team come out with a greater intensity, with a greater sense of urgency. They've heard it all week that the Colts, you know, they're one of those teams you can't trust once they get into the postseason, but they're showing up here today.
Punt from Chad Stanley after that stick from Nick Harper. Return man Troy Walters, fair catch, and he brings it in cleanly at the 26-yard line. Happy holidays, everybody. We are scoreless in the first in Houston.
Congratulations! You've launched the pink slip virus. Your office is now infected. They'll soon trace it back to you. Good luck finding a new job.
Congratulations! Want to get away? Now you can with Southwest Airlines Internet Specials for just $39 to $99 when you purchase by January 19th, only at southwest.com.
You are now free to move about the country.
Well, 'tis that season. This year, find some joy of your own, as well as special financing, at Acura's Joy to the Road, now until January 5th, 2004.
Feeling trapped because you're attached to your wireless number? Take your number to a better place. Call 1-800-T-MOBILE today and get the best value in wireless.
T-Mobile, get more.
Michael Jackson, for the first time since his arrest, talks to Ed Bradley, and only Ed Bradley, tonight on 60 Minutes.
The Naval Criminal Investigative Service takes any case that threatens our military, even on Air Force One.
Cover the president.
Freeze!
Navy, NCIS, CBS Tuesday.
In that loss to Denver last week, the Colts had 183 total yards, lowest output since 1998 against San Diego. And Indianapolis is trying to end the regular season on a high note, getting a win and also taking the AFC South title. They open up this drive with a first and 10 at the 26. And Manning out of the gun. Fake the handoff. Manning, heavy rush, and he is dumped. Steve Foley and Junior Iwani.
Yeah, this is something you don't see much from this Texans defense this year, and that is a sack on the quarterback. Came in with only 18 on the year. That's the second worst total in the National Football League. But early on, Dom Capers is going to send him because he knows that Peyton Manning wants to come in throwing the football.
Chicago, the only team in the NFL with less sacks than Houston. Give Foley the sack on that play. Second down on the give. Edger and James cutting through that hole and able to bring it back past the original line of scrimmage. Tupe Pico with a key block, a 10-yard gain.
And during the break, Marcus Allen had mentioned, and there is a player down on the field right now, but Marcus Allen had mentioned on the previous possession that the Colts had decided to throw the ball on a third and one instead of giving it to Edgerrin James. They give it to him right there on the draw play, and that will slow down the pass rush.
Injury to Junior Iwani, fourth year out of Arizona State, the former Raider. We'll come back after this.
Seven passenger, electronic four-wheel drive, Acura MDX. Power and safety, living in perfect harmony.
Introducing Subway's new Atkins-friendly wraps, like the savory chicken bacon ranch wrap and the turkey and bacon melt wrap, packed with all the delicious taste you'd expect from Subway, but with under 11 net carbs. They'll help you satisfy your low-carb goals. As for your other goals, like avoiding your in-laws indefinitely, well, there you're on your own. The new Atkins Friendly Wraps from Subway. Good, so you don't always have to be.
Ebert and Roper give Stuck on You two thumbs up.
You can do that with three hands tied behind our backs.
It's double the fun with enormous heart.
She's the girl from Jingpanatu, Nai, China.
2003's funniest comedy. Stuck on You, rated PG-13, now playing.
I know a little something about making good moves.
Make your move. Talk to your doctor about Viagra today.
To learn more, race over to Viagra.com.
The NFL on CBS is sponsored by Southwest Airlines. Friendly nonstop service all across the country. Southwest Airlines, a symbol of freedom. Viagra. Ask your doctor if Viagra is right for you. And by Bud Light, for the great taste that won't fill you up and never let you down. Make it a Bud Light.
Junior Iwani able to walk off to the sideline. This team has already lost Seth Payne and Gary Walker throughout the season on the D-line. This is a third and 10 for Indianapolis. Dime package for Houston. On third down, Manning has the time, throws too high, looking for Brandon Stokley. And the Colts will punt again.
And iron on this play. Stokely's open, but it's a different look. And this is what Dom Capers does. He brings the exotic blitzes, only electing to go with two down linemen that time. Only two linebackers. There are six defensive backs in the game. And then you see Sharper and Foreman are your two down or linebackers. And then Foley comes up and he provides the passers. But look, Stokely's open. So it's a different look that time for Peyton Manning, and that's why he can't hit a receiver who's wide open on the play.
Second punt of the day for Hunter Smith. J.J. Moses waiting for it at his own 32. Smith, high punt, sending Moses back to the 25. Here's Moses. Little juke move, stays on his feet. And Moses advances it to the 33-yard line. Justin Snow, the snapper, makes the play after the 49-yard punt. Texans on offense when we return.
Real man of genius.
Today we salute you, Mr. Way Too Much Cologne Wearer. Like a bullhorn, your cologne announces your arrival four blocks before you get there.
Here it comes now.
Here a splish, there a splash. You don't stop till every square inch of manhood is covered.
Everywhere a splish splash.
So crack open an ice cold Bud Light, Mr. Way Too Much Cologne Wearer.
Way Too Much Cologne Wearer.
Imagine one day you realized everyone was imitating you, mimicking your every move, trying to be just like you. Now you know what it must feel like to be the Accord. From Honda, often imitated, never equaled.
What's that?
The wireless bill.
Frustrated with your high wireless bill? Take your number to a better place. Switch to T-Mobile, the best value in wireless. And now get T-Mobile 3-day weekends with unlimited calling.
T-Mobile, get more. Our favorite way to celebrate the holidays? Catching up with old friends.
Taking time to volunteer.
Hanging out with friends and family.
Giving. From all of us at CBS.
Happy holidays.
Happy holidays.
Happy holidays.
Happy holidays.
Texans have lost three straight, four of their last five. Tight one last week. 27-24 loss to Tennessee. Steve McNair driving his team down the field late and hitting Drew Bennett for the game-winning score. They played in a lot of close games, especially here at home this season. On a first and 10 from the 34. Carr, look at the time. Sets it up for Dominic Davis. And Davis across the 40-yard line on that flip for 8 yards. Marcus Washington, the tackle for Indy. Coming up tonight on 60 Minutes, Michael Jackson, for the first time since his arrest, talks with Ed Bradley, and only Ed Bradley. See this exclusive interview tonight. 60 Minutes here on CBS. Second and two now for Houston. No score. Under 10 minutes to go in this first quarter. Davis in the backfield with Moran Norris. They give it to Davis. Running into a crowd, and he comes up short of a first down. A 1 yard gain. Washington again makes the stop for the Colts.
And Ian, so much has been said about this run defense for the Indianapolis Colts. You know, they're used to playing that Tampa 2, that cover 2 zone that Tony Dungy had in Tampa Bay, but they haven't been able to run much of it. They're having to bring the safeties up in the box to help try to defend the run. So they need that 8th guy in the box. And look at the run defense under Jim Mora. Not much better since Tony Dungy has come over in terms of points allowed and yards allowed.
On third down, Carr throws it. Broken up along the sideline. Good play by Harper in a matchup with a veteran Corey Bradford.
Oh, it was a wonderful play by Nick Harper. Showing excellent footwork, and he'll come out of the break. And this is what you're looking for in an NFL cornerback, because his back is turned to the quarterback. And then once he turns around, look how he gets a hand around, able to knock the ball down without interfering with the receiver.
Still no first downs here in this first quarter. And another punt for Chad Stanley. Troy Walters standing at his own 10-yard line. Spiraling kick. Walters ranges over. He wants to return it from the 10. Walters cannot get to the 15-yard line, and Jason Simmons made sure of it. Indy deep in their own territory after the 4-yard return.
Most families, we wanted an SUV, but ours had to be especially rugged because my husband was brought up by wolves. But he's really not that different than any other guy. You know, he loves to be outdoors, so we bought a Honda Pilot.
Hey, Dad!
And that's been a lifesaver, really.
The Pilot, built by Honda.
There's a man who leads a life of danger. Everyone he meets, he stays a stranger. Every move he makes, and every chance he takes. Odds are he won't live to see tomorrow.
Nothing makes a sandwich like a Pepsi. It's the cola.
If staying in the game is important to you, ask your doctor about new Levitra. Make this the play that matters. Take action. And ask your doctor if a free sample is right for you. Now's the time to ask about new Levitra.
An ordinary man is about to become an extraordinary hero.
Move away from her!
In the movie nominated for 8 Golden Globe Awards, including Best Picture of the Year, Cold Mountain, rated R, now playing everywhere.
The NFL on CBS is sponsored by T-Mobile. Get more minutes, more features, more service. And by the Pilot, built by Honda. It gets you surprisingly close to nature.
The Indianapolis Colts have the number 3 rated offense in the NFL, number 1 in passing numbers this season, and so far, 9 total yards in their first 2 possessions. They take over with a 1st and 10 at the 13-yard line for Peyton Manning. On the ground, Edgerrin James. Cutting it to the outside, and James is twirled down by Jay Foreman. That's a 6-yard gain for James.
And the Colts go out 3 and out on their first 2 possessions. Normally, the Texans will run a 3-4 defense, and Dom Capers right now giving the Colts a different look. They're using 2 down linemen, Steve Martin and Jerry DeLoach, going with the 4 linebackers and bringing on a 4th defensive back. You'll see different types of rotation in terms of personnel on defense from Dom Capers all day.
Jamie Sharper told us he likes the chess match between the defense and Manning, and you're seeing it right now. Manning checking off the line of scrimmage. Crowd trying to increase the volume on 2nd down. Switch to a running play, and it's James banging his way across the 25, and a 1st down, our 1st of the day.
Oh, watch, this is Tarik Glenn, big 78, the tackle pulling, but watch DeLoach, 95, see the extension, separation, then he comes off the block, and he's able to make the tackle. It's just an excellent play by defensive end. You saw a big guy moving, running fast down the line, then separating, getting off the block to make the tackle.
7-yard pickup for James. And a new set of downs for Indianapolis to work with, under 8 minutes to go on the 1st. On 1st down, Manning, quick toss, the connection made to Marcus Pollard. And he is spilled out across the 35, combination of Sharper and Wong. And it's good for a 10-yard gain and a 1st down.
Marcus Pollard is the bailout guy for this offense. And Manning told us he thought that Pollard would have a big game today and felt like he should have had a big game last week against Denver where he dropped some important balls. But today he's going to have another opportunity to make up for it.
No huddle offense for Indy on a 1st and 10 from the 36. Manning directing traffic. Long count for the Pro Bowl. Go to the running play, and it's James stacked up at the 40-yard line. He gains 4 on 1st down. Steve Martin involved in the stop for Houston.
Boy, Steve Foley, he can come off the ball. That linebacker came over from the Cincinnati Bengals that had been released in training camp. He came off the ball, and that's what forced Edgerrin James to cut it up the field because he came off on Tarik Glenn, the left tackle, and got the penetration Dom Capers loved to see from his defensive front.
Houston ranked 29th in the NFL against the run. On the ground again, and James doesn't have much room to work with. 4-yard gain. Jason Simmons, first man there, able to shoot through the hole to make the stop.
Oh, once again, Tarik Glenn. That time he got the chop block on Steve Foley. But Foley was still able to come off and make the tackle. So they're starting to get some good pressure up front. And then watch it here. See, he'll get chop blocked, but watch him get back up, and he's still able to make the tackle along with Jay Foreman. So good play at the point of attack from this defensive line for the Houston Texans.
Looking to convert on 3rd down. This is a 3rd and 2 for the Colts. Crowd cranking it up here at Reliant. On the handoff, big hole for Edgerrin James, and loses the ball at the end of the play. Colts able to recover it at the 40-yard line of Houston. Rick DeMulling, the left guard, able to cover up 16-yard burst.
Well, DeMulling who gets the block that springs the hole for Edgerrin James. And then after the fumble, then DeMulling continues up the field, C64, he'll get on the football. So the left guard's making a big play, getting a tremendous block and coming away with the football.
7 carries, 45 yards for Edgerrin James. Colts putting it together on this drive. It's Manning to throw, mixing it up. And he hits his man, Brandon Stokely, for a solid gainer on 1st down. 7 yards, Jay Foreman, the tackle for Houston.
The no huddle is meant to keep a certain personnel defensively on the field for the Houston Texans. Tony Dungy, he doesn't want Dom Capers rotating guys in and out. Once you get a look at a personnel, you go no huddle to keep those guys on the field, and maybe you can make an adjustment as Peyton Manning make play call at the line of scrimmage.
And they like the no huddle on the road, trying to quell the crowd noise. Don't give them that much time to rev it up on a second and three. Manning, a fake, throws it to the sideline. Incomplete. Marvin Harrison, along with DeMarcus Fagans, and tight coverage for the youngster.
Yeah, Fagans is right in the hip pocket of Marvin Harrison. Watch the block. See the jam there, and see he's right where you want to be. That's great position, even though the ball's thrown behind Marvin Harrison intentionally on that stop fade. Harrison's not able to come away with the ball because, you know, Fagans had really good coverage on the play.
Ninth play of the drive. On a third and three. Shotgun, Manning. Here comes the rush. Manning steps forward, throws a floater, is caught by Stokely. And a first down for Indianapolis, just shy of the 25-yard line. A six-yard pickup through the air. Busy day in the NFL. Let's go to New York. Jim Nance.
All right. Thank you, Ian and Salman. We're going to keep you posted on that Titans game after a Gary Anderson field goal. Martin Gramatica matches it from 27 yards. 3-3 first quarter at Tennessee. Neil O'Donnell at quarterback. Let's go back to you.
And even with a loss here by India, a loss for Tennessee would give the Colts the division title. We'll keep you posted throughout the day around the National Football League. Under 4 minutes to go. First quarter here at Houston. On a first and 10, Manning out of the gun. Steps up, looking for the long ball. And broken up. It looked like Stokely may have touched the football that was intended for Marvin Harrison.
Yeah, you had two receivers in the same area, and Stokely understands he wasn't supposed to be there. You saw Peyton Manning suggest, what are you doing there? Because he takes his defender in the same area where Harrison is going for the ball. And see, look, Harrison was open, even though Fagans may have been the one to get a ball in there, I should say a hand on the ball, but Peyton Manning's really upset. He's like, you've got to get wider. We can't have you in that area so that he can complete the pass for a touchdown to Marvin Harrison.
Now, the problem right now for Houston, though, DeMarcus Fagans is on the ground. We'll step aside.
Drink intelligently. A reminder from Smirnoff Ice Triple Black Premium Malt Beverage, proud sponsor of 2003 Winston Cup champion Matt Kenseth and the number 17 car.
The new Sonic Air Elite by Philips. With patented sonic technology, its bristle tips move three times faster for a deep cleaning experience unlike any other.
For whiter teeth and healthier gums, stop brushing. Start Sonic Air.
Ease into retirement with the third largest public company in the world. Retirement, loans, insurance. AIG. We know money.
A diamond ring means one thing. The gig is up, baby. Bye-bye, bachelorhood. It's a long talk with Jean-Pierre about princess cuts and tapered baguettes. But that was before the awakening, before the playoffs. Now a diamond ring is the reason we're here. Because of a diamond ring, everyone knows how to pronounce Favre. It's the outlaw Josie Wales riding into town willing to right the wrongs of seasons past. The playoffs made diamonds a guy's best friend and turned a diamond ring into a diamond ring.
CBS Monday. Was it self-defense or murder?
No!
One agent goes up against Miami's most ruthless attorney.
You're lying.
You don't have any proof.
Don't miss Monday's number one drama.
I hope you have good cause for bringing us here.
How would murder be?
It'd be great if you had the evidence.
CSI Miami, CBS Monday.
DeMarcus Fagans getting his first NFL start, trying to jog off the field. Fagans was hurt on that pass coverage with Marvin Harrison. 17 players on injured reserve. That is the most in the NFL. Fagans, nicknamed Petey, His grandmother gave him the nickname because she thought he looked like the dog from the Little Rascals.
Well, with Aaron Glenn out and Kenny Wright both on injured reserve, they bring up DeMarcus Fagans. And I see why he got the start, because he's been doing a phenomenal job of covering Marvin Harrison so far in this game.
They bring an extra lineman in, and Derek Vaughn has now checked in. Former Atlanta Falcon on a 2nd and 10. 3:31 to go, first quarter. Indianapolis, 11th play of the drive. Running play, Edgerrin James. And a lot of blue jerseys in the area. Wong and Martin there. It's a 3-yard gain. Let's go downstairs to Marcus Allen.
Well, thanks, Ian. As you can tell, Edgerrin James is starting to build up a lather. Great running backs need the football. What happens is, I used to get disinterested when I was a decoy, when I didn't get into the game early. I think that the Colts made a mistake of not going on that 3rd and 1. They realized they got to get him the ball. It only will make the offensive plays, the passing plays, much better, guys.
8 carries, 48 yards for James today. And normally they do feed him the football 20-plus times. Last week he was taken out of his game, as was the entire Colts offense. On 3rd down, Manning steps up. Manning on the flip. Reggie Wayne trying to create after the catch. And it will be very close to a 1st down. Derek Vaughn got over there defensively.
Boy, Peyton Manning, he's like an android. He's like a computer. He was surveying the entire football field, looking up, and then watch. You're going to see the receiver, Reggie Wayne, come across at the last minute and watch Peyton just flicking the ball. See there? He just gets him the ball because he says, well, you're my 5th option. After watching the 1st, 2nd, 3rd, and 4th guy in the progression, he checks it down to Wayne, and they're going to come close to picking up the 1st down. So Peyton Manning does a wonderful job at processing so much information rather quickly, and then he's making the right decision by getting the football to Reggie Wayne.
They extend the chains, and you see how short they are. Just about the length of the football, 4th and inches, or you're looking at a 35 or 36-yard field goal from the man that has been the most consistent in the NFL this year, Mike Vanderjagt.
And you heard Marcus Allen talk about, you know, the running game and Edgerrin James helping the passing game. You often hear people talk about balance, but more importantly, you have to allow the defense to guess a little bit. They don't know what the coach is doing, and the more they can hammer the running game, I think it frees up Peyton Manning to make even bigger plays, because they force the safety to come up in the box and respect their ability to run the football.
They are going to go for it on 4th and inches, 11 of 16 on 4th down conversions this season. The 13th play of the drive with James and the fullback Tom Lipinski now in there. Double tight end set, Pollard and Joe Dean Davenport. 4th and inches for Indy. Lipinski in motion. Manning, handoff. James is tripped up. Edgerrin James fell over his own man, Rick DeMulling, and he did not get to the marker.
Well, you know why he wasn't going to be able to get to the marker? The Texans, they crowded the box with 10 defensive players. They had 10 guys at the box, and they were able to shut down Edgerrin James and send him back. No 1st down for the Indianapolis Colts.
It's here! The new AOL disc is here.
Can't believe that it's done.
Hold on. That's AOL 9.0 Optimize you've got there.
It's Jerry Stiller.
You've been getting lots of discs, I know, but you got to give 9.0 a spin. Try it. I'll bet you'll be using an old Snoop Dogg CD to finish that lock work.
Now wait just one minizzle.
Satisfaction guaranteed for 90 days or your money back.
Introducing Subway's new Atkins-friendly wraps, like the savory chicken bacon ranch wrap and the turkey and bacon melt wrap. Packed with all the delicious taste you'd expect from Subway, but with under 11 net carbs, they'll help you satisfy your low-carb goals. As for your other goals, like avoiding your in-laws indefinitely, well, there you're on your own. The new Atkins-friendly wraps from Subway. Good, so you don't always have to be.
Hurry in to Circuit City's Red Dot Sale today. Look for the red dot and get extra savings in every department. Save up to $430 on desktop packages and notebook computers. Save up to $75 on digital cameras. And save on mobile and portable DVD players, too, like this 5.8-inch widescreen portable DVD player, just $169.99 after price break and mail-in rebate. Don't miss the savings at our huge Red Dot sale. Circuit City, we're with you.
Now, here's a play that Peyton Manning has to check out of, because look, they have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then they're going to bring a seventh over when Lipinski motions too many guys to block. And Lipinski tips off the hand of the offense. That's the side they want to block. No way they can run the ball where there's more defenders than they can block and still pick up the first down.
And Houston, by virtue of their defense, takes over. First and 10 at the 19. David Carr on the screen pass. Dominic Davis dances his way out across the 20-yard line, and a modest gain of 3 on first down. David Macklin with a tackle on the perimeter.
Yeah, we have a game of chess match between really two great defensive-minded coaches. Dom Capers, of course, has led some really wonderful defenses when he was with the Saints, the Pittsburgh Steelers, and Carolina Panthers. We all know about what Tony Dungy can do, what he did in Tampa, and now with the Indianapolis Colts. So they're playing a great game of chess on both sides of the ball.
On a 2nd and 7 now for Houston. Hard count by Carr. Handoff. Davis to the outside, and Davis angles his way out of bounds, just a little bit shy of a first down. Steve McKinney pulling to help out.
Yeah, McKinney gets out in front. Weary also 61, give it the kick out, and it's the decisiveness and really the aggressive running style of Dominic Davis that allows him to get to the corner. He's really made this offense very proud, because we all know how bad they were 1 year ago in terms of their run blocking ability and their inability to protect the quarterback. But he's made this an entirely different offense because he's a tremendous weapon out of the backfield.
Now 56 yards shy of 1,000 in his rookie season. 3rd and 1. Bootleg. Carr throwing. Tip ball. And incomplete. He was looking for Norris. And Raheem Brock may have gotten a piece of it. 4th and 1 as we head to New York at Jim Nantz.
All right, Ian, tonight Baltimore takes on Pittsburgh, and the Ravens are battling Cincinnati for the North title. Bengals trying to do their part today. They've now taken a 7-3 lead on Rudy Johnson's 5-yard run. Let's go back to you.
Bengals trying to keep some pressure on the Ravens. A punt from Chad Stanley. Troy Walters, fair catch. And he hauls it in at the 25-yard line. 47-yard punt for Stanley. Coming up Monday on The Late Show, Dave welcomes Julia Roberts, and later this week, catch Madonna, Russell Crowe, Amanda Peet, and Kirsten Dunst. Plus, music from Pink and Rod Stewart. All this week on The Late Show. Well, the roof is closed here today at Reliant Stadium, and they made that decision at 10:30. Some rain in the forecast, and it's a nice luxury to have. The roof will be closed for Super Bowl 38 when it's played here
February. It is a wonderful venue for a big game like the Super Bowl. And what I like is, see, that roof is closed, but you still get the natural lighting that you're like. It's not a dark, dank stadium like what we've seen in some domes.
1st and 10 with under a minute to go in the first quarter. No score, Indianapolis and Houston. Here's Manning. Throwing on first down to Stokely. And Stokely brings it in for a 9-yard pickup. Steve Foley with a stop. Solomon DeMarcus Fagans, they are X-raying his lower left leg right now. We'll get your report on that as soon as we get the info.
Tremendous loss because, you know, they have Marcus Coleman. They've already lost Kenny Wright and Aaron Glenn. So Fagans are really their fourth corner. Now they're working with their fifth corner and Derek Vaughn. And you know what? The ability does drop off when you get to your fourth and fifth player on that side of the ball.
On 2nd and short, James carries for 2. Steve Foley, the hit. And a 1st down for Indianapolis, which will be the final play of this first quarter. Now, Peyton Manning felt that the offense was exposed last week in that loss to Denver. Houston may be copying a page out of the Broncos playbook, doing a good job defensively through the first quarter of action. No score. 2nd quarter play is coming up from Houston after this.
The difference in carbs between Miller Lite and Coors Light is only 1.8 grams. You can burn 1.8 grams dancing. Slow dancing. So do a little dance and drink a little Rocky Mountain Cold Coors Light.
Hey,
Hey, Bob. You get a new haircut?
No.
Hey, Bob.
Hey.
Did you lose weight?
Nope.
What's different? He finally asked his doctor about Viagra. Find out if a free sample is right for you.
Did you just talk to the doctor?
Yep.
Ask your doctor and see the difference.
I think you should see this.
It's just a kid. Homo habilis was the first to use tools.
This is a G chord.
He's learning, absorbing. He's getting smarter every day.
A player who makes a team great is more valuable than a great player.
We've always watched the stars. If you look at the sky, you can see the beginning of time.
Collecting data is only the first step toward wisdom, but sharing data is the first step toward community.
Chaos theory. Everything's about timing, kid.
Poetry.
Aeronautics. Plumbing.
What he learns, we all learn. What he knows, we all benefit from.
Faster, better, cheaper.
Speak your mind. Don't back down.
Does he have a name?
His name is Linux.
Star Search, TV's original talent show, is back with a brand new twist.
This is not your father's Star Search.
New singers and dancers face off. Plus, your favorites return when the stars of tomorrow challenge past champions in the winner's circle. Arsenio Hall hosts the all-new Star Search, CBS, Saturday, January 17th.
Houston is yet to register a first down. As we start play in the second quarter, Ian Eagle, Solomon Wilcox, Marcus Allen with you on CBS. No score. The Colts and the Texans. Question marks surrounding Indianapolis after their loss to Denver last week. They were hoping to answer them quickly here today. They got no points in the first quarter, though. Shotgun on a first and 10. Fake the handoff. Manning. Throwing over the middle and complete to Marvin Harrison. Into Houston territory, and an 18-yard hookup as Marlon McCree brings him down.
That was a nicely designed play against his own defense that time. You'll see he'll just slow, and it's his timing. He doesn't come flying at full speed across the field. See how he just settles down? Because he knows where the hole is, and Marvin Harrison does a good job understanding where the hole is going to be created, in that zone defense. He finds it, settled down, and give his quarterback a target to complete the pass.
And a first and 10 at the Houston 46. James and Rhodes split in the backfield. Hand it off. It's Dominique Rhodes. A little change of pace as he sticks the helmet down and goes to the 40-yard line. Sharper and Martin combined to bring him down. A 6-yard gain.
And we just showed you the numbers on the Indianapolis Colts offense. 5 first downs. Now 6 at this point in the game. But they're going to have to begin to put some points on the board and have something to show for all their work so far in the game.
They are 3 points away from setting a new club record for most points in a season. It has been a prolific year offensively for Manning and the Colts. Last week, a different story. 2nd and 4. Manning on the toss for James. Makes a move to the outside and forced out of bounds by Marcus Coleman. A first down for Indy, 6-yard pickup.
And you might ask, why is it important for them to get some points on the board? As you see, they'll whip this ball over to Edgerrin James coming out of the backfield. But, you know, Jamie Sharper told us, he said, we have to stay close in this game. And I think the longer they stay close, I think the pressure begins to mount on the Indianapolis Colts, who are supposed to come in here and clinch a division title and win this game easily. Well, it's not going to be so easy against this Texans defense today.
Good balance on the offensive end so far, mixing up the run and the pass. Indy with a first and 10 at the 34 of Houston. Give it to James. And Edgerrin James able to explode through that hole and gain 9. Tarik Glenn on the left side with a good block up front.
Well, this is what Marcus Allen was asking for. Hey, give the runner the ball. He's going to work over to the right side, but watch him cut it back over to the left side behind Tarik Glenn, and that's where he finds some room to run. But he's right. Edgerrin James is starting to get a rhythm in this game, and he's starting to get it going.
And a 2nd and 1 now for Indy. Early 2nd quarter. It's James again. And sidesteps his way to another Indianapolis first down. That's a 2-yard pickup.
Why would you not give him the ball? This is as fresh as Tony Dungy has said. It's James has been in the month of December in quite some time, and he's feeling it, and he's fresh. You got to get him going, because we know as we get into the postseason, he's going to have to be a factor in this offense. Look at the time of possession right now. Indianapolis just eating time away off the clock.
And quite a difference from a week ago when Denver controlled it 44 minutes and 58 seconds to Indianapolis' 15 minutes and 2 seconds. Handoff. James wanted a blocker and didn't have one in front of him. James spun down, a gain of one. Jamie Sharper able to sniff that one out along the sideline.
This defense, that Dom Capers said, what we want to do is show up and we want to fight. And watch Stokely, he's going to try to get a block here. Look at that. He actually does knock down Steve Foley, who tries to knife underneath. Stokely was able to pick up a block on the linebacker.
Now Dominic Rhodes is in there. James gets a breather. On a second and nine for the Colts. Long drive for Indianapolis. Manning to put it in the air. Almost intercepted. Kai Lee Wong had it in his breadbasket. Marvin Harrison, the intended target. Let's head back to New York. Jim Nantz with an update.
All right, guys, here's a worthy highlight. Dolphins hosting the Jets today, and watch this effort here by Ricky Williams. 16 yards right over and through the Jets defense, and Miami's in front here, 13-0 second quarter. Let's go back to you.
Early in the year, Jim and Solomon, I think everyone thought he was going to have an immense season. It never really turned out that way.
Yeah, because they need to create more balance. I think they relied on Ricky Williams too heavily at the beginning of the year. And you have to ask other playmakers to step up in that offense for the Miami Dolphins.
10th play of the drive, out of the shotgun, on third down. Manning forced out of the pocket. Manning looking to get rid of it and throws it away. The Houston defense applied the pressure with Steve Foley and Jay Foreman chasing down Manning.
Well, this week I talked to the Texans defensive coordinator, Vic Fangio. He said, our problem is we haven't been able to get pressure on the quarterback. He said, if we can get pressure on Peyton Manning, it's going to go a long way in helping us to stay close and possibly win this football game. So they're sending the boys after Peyton, forcing him to run out of the pocket.
Mike Vanderjagt looking to tie the NFL record with 40 consecutive field goals made. This is from 39 yards away. Vanderjagt, the kick. He's got it. Mike Vanderjagt is in the record books, along with Gary Anderson from the Vikings back in 97-98. 3-0 Colts.
This year, get everything on your wish list. Announcing the Lincoln Mercury Wish List Year-End Event with savings on every Lincoln and Mercury, including Lincoln Navigator, the midsize Lincoln Aviator, and Mercury Mountaineer. Now get a no-charge DVD entertainment system plus $2,000 cash back on every Lincoln and Mercury SUV. And see the all-new Mercury Monterey, our safest minivan ever, during the Wish List Year-End Event. See your Lincoln Mercury dealer today.
To protect a secret, they erased his memory. Now, 19 clues will show him how to collect on the life he lost.
Hang on! Don't you believe in second chances?
Paycheck, rated PG-13. Now playing in theaters everywhere.
I know a little something about making good moves.
Make your move. Talk to your doctor about Viagra today.
To learn more, race over to Viagra.com.
The National Football League family is committed to supporting the courageous men and women serving in the U.S. Armed Forces in the Mideast. But the fight for freedom is not without loss. And the NFL urges you to join us and the Intrepid Fallen Heroes Fund in supporting the military families of those heroes who have sacrificed their lives in the service of our country. Please visit NFL.com/Heroes Fund and help support those families in need.
This week, join us for an amazing and memorable look back at all that's happened in 2003, our astonishing, unforgettable year in review on The Early Show.
He preyed on single women and never got caught. Now a new tip will start the hunt again.
He's already stalking someone right now.
I want Skype.
A special cold case, CBS Thursday.
Colts get on the board, a 3-0 lead after the field goal from Mike Vanderjagt, 39 yards, an 11-play, 54-yard drive, took up just over 5 minutes of action. And that seems to be the theme here in Houston. They don't want the Colts to win this division in their house. Meanwhile, Indianapolis wants to make a return trip to Houston for the Super Bowl. Here on CBS, J.J. Moses on the return. Moses, some blockers in front of him, and he is spun around at the 33-yard line by Donald Strickland. 21-yard return. Texans offense is back on the field when we come back.
I don't want to get married to a boy. They all weird. Their parents start crying in the aisle. And they make a big scene. And then, like, there'd be a river of cries, like, right in the middle of the aisle. And everybody would start crying. I just prefer a wedding dress.
Can't taste my beer.
I can't taste my beer.
I can't taste my beer.
I can't taste my beer!
I can't taste my beer.
I can't taste my beer! I can't taste my beer!
Next time, try the light beer that actually tastes like beer. Great tasting, less filling, Miller Lite. Good call.
What's everyone talking about this holiday season? The Verizon Wireless The Return of the King Text to Win sweepstakes. Because with unlimited family calling anytime minutes, that's right, anytime minutes on the America's Choice National Family Share Plan, your family can talk about it as much as they want. Just text the word WIN to the number 5687 to enter for a chance to win a home theater system. Verizon Wireless, we never stop working for you. The Lord of the Rings, The Return of the King, in theaters now.
The NFL on CBS is sponsored by the next Ford F-150, 2004 Motor Trend Truck of the Year, John Hancock, official worldwide sponsor of the Olympic Games, and by Miller, there's good enough and there's better than it has to be. Miller, good call.
Well, guys, in that last possession, the Texans are doing exactly what they want to. I talked to Steve Martin, the defensive tackle. He says we want to hit Peyton every chance we get. We want to hit him, and we want to make him play faster than he wants to play. And on critical downs, guys, they've been successful. They haven't been successful all the time, but in critical downs, they've done a good job. Back upstairs.
There's no doubt, and they're putting a body on Peyton Manning as well, even after he released the football, gave him something to think about. On first down, quick out, good cut. Andre Johnson, a first down, the first of the day for the Houston offense. He made Nick Harper miss. And a 12-yard pickup, Johnson doing the legwork. Let's head back to New York, Jim Nance.
All right, Ian, here's an update from Tennessee. Again, Neil O'Donnell at quarterback, the snap from the 40. Look into the end zone, looking for Drew Bennett, and the play is made by Dwight Smith. The pick in the end zone remains 3-3. Let's go back to Ian Solomon in Houston.
Neil O'Donnell in at quarterback for the Tennessee Titans. You just never know what to expect in this league. Late in the year, signing on O'Donnell. Here's Carr, throwing off his back foot, knocked up in the air, and broken up. Johnson, he took a hit. Harper and Strickland there defensively, and a little chatting afterwards, a flag down.
Oh, David Carr also takes a hit in the backfield, and there's a flag down. You see he's going to get whacked right there by Dwight Freeney, and there comes the flag.
10-yard penalty. Repeat first down.
And it is Chester Pitts called on the hold as we get the word from Ed Hockley, first flag of the day.
Well, Andre Johnson was up the field. I'm not sure if that is not pass interference because Harper was banging Johnson all the way up the field, well beyond the 5-yard area where you can make contact with the receiver.
Chester Pitts, he has played every offensive snap in the Texans 2 years, started as a rookie out of San Diego State, allowed 12 sacks last year, only 6 this season. So improvement on that offensive line. On the toss, Dominic Davis creating after the catch, and Davis slides down across the 40-yard line for an 8-yard completion.
Wow, he showed me something on that play because he catches this ball out of the backfield, and why there are two defenders for the Indianapolis Colts who should have the tackle right here. Look, he makes two guys miss and is able to squeeze through there and pick up additional yards. So he's clever, he's shifty, he has the power and the leg, I tell you what, he's going to be an exceptional back, and he's going to add to a trio of offensive players who can put up some big numbers for Houston.
He was a backup at LSU, now a starter in the NFL. Here's Carr. Protection is there. Another dump ball. This time, Davis accelerates. A first down for Houston in Indianapolis territory at the 45-yard line. 13 yards on that pass play.
Well, we saw Davis catch the ball out of the backfield. He's going to do it again. But it's his ability to make players miss in the open field that makes him exceptional. You see Strickland with the whiff, and then he takes it to the next level. And in this league, in the National Football League, you have to be able to make players miss in the open field.
And the dinking and dunking is working on this drive. On a first and 10, Indianapolis with a 3-0 lead, 8.5 to go, second quarter. Handoff. Davis, he's got a lane. Dominic Davis out across the 25-yard line. 21-yard first for the rookie Davis. First down, Houston, as we head to New York and Jim.
All right, guys, again, keeping an eye on the Titans here. Bucks and Titans tied at 3. Brad Johnson, watch this play. Picked by Javon Kearse. First interception of his career. First and goal for the Titans. Let's go back to Houston.
Standings in the AFC South, Indy and Tennessee all tied, but the Colts knocked off the Titans twice, and they win the tiebreak. First down for Houston at the Colt 23. Carr, again, that quick toss. Johnson able to break one tackle, but then brought down at the 20-yard line by Larry Triplett, the defensive lineman, getting to the outside. 3-yard gain. Don't forget, coming up, Nextel Halftime Report, Jim, Dan, Dion, and Boomer. All of today's scores and highlights, plus Philadelphia Eagles, Brian Dawkins, Darwin Walker, all coming up. Nextel Halftime Report. Call it a second and 6. Houston finally accumulating some yardage on this drive. A 4-receiver look on second down. Carr looks downfield. Carr out of the pocket. Tuck and run for Carr, and he veers out of bounds. It's a 1-yard scramble for David Carr.
And this is what Dom Capers talked about. You know, David Carr has missed 4 games this year, he said, but this is what he gives us that the other guys don't. That's the mobility at the quarterback position, to be able to buy more time and allow his guys to get open, something Dom Capers really likes about David Carr is his temperament and, you know, his psychological makeup. He is a true leader on this football team. We talked about those trio of players. They've been the guys who made it happen on this drive. David Carr, Andre Johnson, and Dominique Davis.
And they have been very good in the red zone this season. Second most efficient in the AFC, 19 touchdowns and 31 trips. On a third, down and 4. Carr on the give. Davis, can he get to the outside? Yes! First down for the Texans. 6-yard run for Dominic Davis. New set of downs for Houston to work with as we head back to New York and Jim Nance.
All right, guys, after 3 running plays by the Titans, they go for it on 4th and goal. And O'Donnell's pass here, broken up by John Lynch. Tampa Bay takes over on downs. What a moment there. Let's go back to you.
Keeping you updated on what's happening around the league, in particular Tennessee, with the interest, of course, Indianapolis. Both teams at 11-4. And Tony Dungy is having a chat right now with Ed Hockley.
There was no challenge on the play, no challenge, first down.
And Dungy's not a guy that throws that red flag.
No, he's one of those guys. He knows the rules. He knows what he sees. He's a bright man, and he has an understanding. Look, has never challenged a call. And he doesn't want to waste timeouts, but he's very aware of what's happening on the football field and has a good, I think, perspective on whether or not, you know, the play was good or whether or not it was bad. And so that's why he's keeping that red flag tucked in his back pocket.
A first and 10 from the 12-yard line. Double tight end set, Kent and Murphy for Houston. Carr is checking off with 5:32 left in the first half. On the handoff, Davis bursting through. Touchdown, Houston.
Chester Pitts had given up the sack and the hit on David Carr earlier. But let me tell you here, if the fullback Norris gets a good block, and so does Chester Taylor, the left tackle. It starts there. See, Bratsky, he moves Bratsky out, and then Norris, he leads it up in there. And again, you hammer away at this Colts defensive front by running the football. That's what everyone else has done, so why should Houston do anything different?
Extra point, Chris Brown, the seventh touchdown of the season for Dominic Davis, the rookie out of LSU. It's Houston in front of Indy, 7-3 in the second.
We engineered a material behind the dash called Quiet Steel. Only the new Ford F-150 has it, which means it's the only truck to deliver this. The sound of quality. The sound of the quietest pickup, period. Only the next F-150 are in the right to be the 2004 Motor Trend Truck of the Year. If you haven't looked at Ford lately, look again.
New plant location?
San Diego.
San Diego?
The ocean.
The sun.
The people.
A problem.
Problem?
Prices.
Big problem. Solution?
Pittsburgh.
Pittsburgh.
Good paper.
Best paper.
Pittsburgh paper. Perfect. Pursue the potential Pittsburgh property pronto. Let's eat.
Nextel walkie-talkies get it done.
Afternoon, ladies.
Hi. You want to join us?
Me? Yeah, sure.
So what do you do?
I sell paper.
That is so interesting.
Really?
Yeah.
Where will you be when your diarrhea comes back? You should have taken Imodium the first time. It stops diarrhea, often in just one dose. Imodium AD.
I'm back.
Don't wait till it's too late.
Rich Eisen, behind the scenes, only on the NFL Network.
Andy Roddick is the U.S. Open champion.
The U.S. Open on CBS Sports.
The Colts defense got shredded by another rookie running back last week, Quentin Griffin from the Denver Broncos. This week, it's Dominic Davis. A touchdown to put Houston ahead, 7-3. And Chris Brown will kick it off for the Texans. Dominique Rhodes, the deep man. And Rhodes takes it in stride from the seven. Rhodes cutting to the perimeter. Here's Rhodes getting to the outside, but a flag comes flying down as he is forced out at the 34-yard line by Brown. Penalty markers, two of them now on the play. And Antoine Peake better watch out. He just took his helmet off and got in the face of Ed Hockley, the rookie out of Cincinnati, third-round pick.
Whoa.
He lost control. And his head coach, Dom Capers, came over to step in. This has been a fast-moving first half. Only one penalty until the two flags that just came down.
And both teams have come out and decided to run the ball, but Dom Capers can't be happy with the antics of Antoine
Peake. There were fouls by both teams on the play during the return holding by the receiving team number 89. There was also a personal foul, unnecessary roughness by the kicking team after the play, number 98. By rule, those fouls offset at the spot of the receiving team's foul. They keep the ball at that spot, first down.
So the Colts will have the football when we come back, trailing 7-3.
We didn't just give the new Ford F-150 more horsepower. We gave it the most low-end torque. Why did we push farther than anyone else? So you could do more than anyone else. Only the next F-150 are in the right to be the 2004 Motor Trend Truck of the Year. If you haven't looked at Ford lately, look again.
Leon, you sign a record contract in the offseason. You come in with great numbers, Hall of Fame caliber numbers. But since then, disappointment. Your numbers are down. Who's to blame?
Well, Chuck, in this situation, I first have to look at myself.
The great ones do.
Right. So since you and I both know that can't be it, I gotta blame the fans and the media. And after that, it's the linemen's fault, it's the coach's fault, the owner's fault, the turf, referees, announcers. May even be your fault, Chuck.
NFL on CBS is sponsored by IBM, official information technology partner of the NFL, and by Imodium. Where will you be when your diarrhea comes back?
Welcome back to Reliant Stadium. Houston 7, Indianapolis 3, 5:15 to go in the first half. Peyton Manning is well aware of the chatter around the NFL. He's going to the Pro Bowl. He's thrown for over 4,000 yards for the fifth straight year, but his postseason record is 0-3, and that seems to be the focus as we get closer to the playoffs.
Well, I was there in the game in 99 against Miami. He took the team right down the field, and it was Vanderjagt who missed the field goal that would have won the game. So, you know, Peyton Manning has done a lot of wonderful things in his career.
From the 29, some trickery. Manning sets it up for Edgerrin James, a stiff arm, and James waltzes out of bounds. After a 5-yard gain, Marcus Coleman got pushed back by James. Well, for Peyton Manning, he knows the history of the game, and you make that next step into superstardom in the postseason.
Yeah, he knows that that's the next level. I mean, it's really the only territory he has yet to conquer in the National Football League as you look at his postseason numbers. He said, but if I do win a postseason game, I'm not going to go and celebrate because I have to come back and play the next week.
On second down, James is cut down by Corey Sears. 3.5-yard gain for Edgerrin James, setting up third and short. Indianapolis 31-17 loss to Denver last week. And that opened some eyes around the NFL. A lot of people focused in on this week to see if they could recover.
Well, even Peyton Manning, as he sat down with us, he said, you know, I feel like we've been exposed. He said, and it's an area of the football team that we're going to have to correct. And he feels like, you know, there's times that I can do maybe more on offense. And I think that's what he's going to have to guard against. He's going to have to be more patient and not try to do too much.
Maybe it would act as a wake-up call, Manning told us, even though he didn't think the team needed one. Out of the shotgun, Manning fires, complete. And Peyton Manning connects with Troy Walters for a first down, a 9-yard gain, and a new set of downs to work with.
But how about Marvin Harrison? I loved his attitude because we talked to him. He said, you know, I told him, what about all these things? People say your team's not physical and that you can't win the big games. He said, I don't know people say those things. He said, I didn't know. He doesn't read the paper. He doesn't listen to talk radio. He just works every day to do his job, and there's no one who's better at it right now.
Out of the shotgun, fake the inside handoff. Manning, long ball, sideline, and picked off by Marcus Coleman. Coleman with a terrific play, and he stays on his feet. Here's Coleman with room to run, looking for the angle. Across the 35, and flags come down. Face mask on Peyton Manning. Trying to get to Coleman, and everything went wrong for Indy on that pass play.
Oh, it sure did, because if this ball is thrown maybe another inch higher, Marvin Harrison, he's going to score a touchdown. See, this ball just another inch over the hand of Marcus Coleman. Goes right to Reggie Wayne, I should say. But what a phenomenal athletic play by Coleman. He gets the interception, and then Peyton Manning, you know, as a quarterback, you just grab what you can get. See there? He grabbed what you can get. Unfortunately, it's the face mask. But he was able to make the tackle and prevent Coleman from returning that interception for a touchdown.
What a sequence here in Houston. For Manning, it is only his 10th interception. For Coleman, it's a career high, his 7th pick. And for Coleman, maybe a little redemption for him after getting beat on that touchdown last week against Tennessee.
With 17 seconds left on the clock, fourth and 10, you're not supposed to get beat deep. Drew Bennett beat Coleman last week, but he said, you know what, I immediately forgot about it. He said, National Football League, you have to have a short memory.
On a first and 10 for Houston at the Indianapolis 19. Handoff, Dominic Davis. And no hole develops. Rob Morris there to help wrap him up. It's a 3-yard gain as we approach 3 minutes to go in the first half.
And I really felt the momentum had shifted on the previous drive by the Houston Texans on that 21-yard run by Dominic Davis. And they really ran downhill, very powerful, asserting their aggression like what Dom Capers wants to see from this offense. And then Moran Norris, the fullback, he had a kickout block on David Macklin, who was a deep leader, and really, I think, changed the tempo of this ball game.
On a second and 7 for Houston. Movement and flags. Dwight Freeney, I have not even called his name yet today.
Offense number 69, 5-yard penalty, second down.
And Chester Pitts is called on the penalty.
Well, let's take a look at that play. Here's Norris, and he's going to come out. Macklin is out there, but it's going to be a de-cleater. But watch the lineman come off the ball. Now watch this de-cleater. Look at this hit on Macklin right there. And that clears the way for Davis to get to the second level where he's able to make players miss. And that, I think, set the tempo and changed, I think, the physical tone of this football game in favor of Houston.
On second and 12, Davis again. And Davis getting across the 20-yard line. Dominic Davis scored that touchdown earlier. He told us his grandmother's birthday today, Leona Williams. And we didn't have the guts to ask how old.
Congratulations and happy birthday.
Woman never has to tell her age.
That's right. I'm not asking.
We backed off. We're journalists, but we're also pretty bright. You don't go there. 2-minute warning.
Play. Big line at the toll booth. You know those electronic passes?
Yeah.
Used to be one lane, then two, now three.
And you don't have one?
No.
It's the on-demand world.
Huh?
Electronic pass connects to toll booth. Toll booth connects to bank. Bank to your credit card. You come in here with your laptop, click, click, pay your bill through the air. But you don't get it, so you wait in line.
That means something.
Ford is understandably proud of its crash protection technologies, particularly as it applies to family vehicles like the Freestar. But I'm a monstrous fan of technology to help you avoid a crash in the first place, like Ford's Advanced Track, a sophisticated system that actually calculates wheel speed, vehicle attitude, even driver input. Technology that works with you to avoid a bad situation.
It truly is smart engineering.
The all-new Ford Freestar. If you haven't looked at Ford lately, look again.
Let me tell you about the number 7. It's a card you fold in poker. Snow White had 7 dwarves because the guy who wrote it got sick of coming up with names. But that was before the playoffs, before the drive, before the comeback kid won back-to-back championships in old age. Now 7 makes people sleep better at night. 7's bigger than a city that's a mile high. That's how important the playoffs are. Before they showed up, 7 was just 13 minus 6. But now 7 is 7.
In men's hoops, North Carolina clashes with Kentucky. Then in women's hoops, Duke collides with Connecticut. And South Carolina battles Minnesota next Saturday on CBS.
Monday on The Late Show, Dave welcomes Julia Roberts. And later this week, catch Madonna, Russell Crowe, Amanda Peet, Kirsten Dunst, plus music from Rod Stewart. All this week on The Late Show.
2 minutes to go. First half here in Houston. Ian Eagle, Solomon Wilcots. Tony Dungy told us how disappointed he was last year. The way Indianapolis ended the season against Jacksonville, they beat them but did not look sharp. And then he felt it carried over into the loss to the Jets in the postseason.
Yeah, and they have a chance to clinch a division title. They lost last week to Denver. And right now they're on the ropes here in Houston because the Houston Texans are beginning to pound at that defense of Tony Dungy, and they're starting to run the ball, something he does not want to see reoccur from what happened last week.
On a 3rd and 9 now for Houston, already in front 7-3. Here's Carr, roll up, looking for it all. He's got it! Andre Johnson! Touchdown, Texans! And David Carr got walloped.
Well, he came through for his quarterback, David Carr. You better make this catch. Carr's going to stand in the pocket and take a hit.
He just said, did he catch it? He didn't know.
He didn't know. He never saw it. Look, he takes the hit for Rob Morris. He's not going to live to tell the tale, but he's working against Macklin, who gets turned around. And look at the positioning. He gets both feet inbounds. Macklin cannot make a play on the ball before Johnson can haul it in.
They may take a look at this one. This is not a challenge in the hands of coaches, but rather upstairs under 2 minutes to go in the second quarter. Taken out of the hands of Tony Dungy.
Well, take a look. And David Carr shows some courage. This is what his teammates like about him, Ian. He'll stand in the pocket to deliver a very accurate pass there. Okay, the right foot's in. Whoa. I don't know. The left one, it's very difficult to tell, but it looked like it may be on the line. See the right foot's there? He wasn't able to drag that left foot, and it's touching the white line. And that's a rookie receiver. And I like Andre Johnson. It was a delight talking to him. But, you know, the veteran guys have a presence of mind to drag that second foot. He wasn't able to drag it, tried to put it down before he went out of bounds. And I don't know, I think the toes of that left foot may be on the line. Okay, there's your right foot. See, he doesn't drag that left foot. Boom, see, he plants it there. I think it's clear that it's on the line. I don't know how clear, but it's got a better look right here. See, I don't see any green between his toes and that white chalk.
And that was third down.
Yeah, it was third down. They may take this one off the board.
Now, David Carr hoping that Johnson was able to drag that foot. He didn't know if Johnson caught it. Obviously, the 70,000 people screaming didn't give him the clear indication that Johnson had brought it in after he took that hit from Rob Morris.
And you see how Johnson came up standing up? You're going to have to drag that left foot. And you're going to fall down in the corner of the end zone. You're going to get a little dirty, but that's what you have to do, I think, in order to secure that catch and make sure you get both feet inbounds.
We asked Andre Johnson about what he needs to work on. He said his route running, a lot of cone running.
Yeah.
He's got to work through that kind of drill to get to that next level as a receiver. There's a lot of God-given ability.
And what that will help him do by doing the cone drills is to stay low through his routes. He'll come out of the breaks faster. He'll come out of his cuts with a better positioning to be able to accelerate and close on the football. And that's what receivers do when they're working those cone drills.
He wears number 80 for his idol, Jerry Rice. And we asked him about watching film early this season. He said, no, I was just watching myself. Then I started picking up some tips. I watched some Marvin Harrison use the route that he had used in a game in practice, and it worked. No,
he's
ad hoc.
Yeah, he's going to school every week.
The decision.
After review, the receiver's second foot lands on the white, making it an incomplete pass. Therefore, it's fourth down and 9 on the 18-yard line. Fourth down.
Well, Solomon, as you said, you did not see green in between the toes and the sideline of the end zone for Andre Johnson. Yeah, it's nullified.
Yeah, it's unfortunate for Andre Johnson because he made a great play, and so did David Carr, who took a shot. And, you know, the fans here in Houston don't want to hear it, but that's what you're looking for. If you're the officials, you have to be able to see some green between the toes of the offensive player and that white line. Johnson, he did make a play, but if he drags that left foot, he'll get it in. But see, try to make the stick. You know, the heel's down, but see, the toes are on the white line, clearly out of bounds.
This will be a 36-yard field goal attempt as Houston tries to extend their lead. Chris Brown, the kicker, Chad Stanley to hold it. From 36 yards away, Brown. It's good. Texans with a 10-3 advantage over Indianapolis. It could have been more, but Johnson unable to get the foot inbound.
The Dolphins will go for it on fourth down. Chambers going to throw over the middle. Hits his man. 15-10. 5 touchdown, Miami. Woo!
Woo! Show your pride. Call 1-877-NFL-SHOP or go to NFLShop on NFL.com for the biggest selection of NFL gear. For a free team catalog, call 1-877-NFL-SHOP.
Now, David Carr has been so proud of this young football team. Felt like they've been fighting every week. Nobody leaves it out in the parking lot here at Reliant Stadium. And he and Mark Brunell were talking recently, and they were talking about next year. The last place team in the division next year in the AFC South could have 9 wins. At least that was part of the fodder they were discussing.
I think this is a very competitive AFC South division. It's only going to get better next year. We talked to Tony Dungy about it. See, when you look at the coaches and Jack Del Rio, and you talk about Tony Dungy, and you're talking about Dom Capers and the other guys, they have a really good nucleus of really young quarterbacks, very good coaches, and good personnel groups. So you know this division is going to be very competitive in years to come.
Jeff Fisher continues to do an incredible job with that Titans team as Brown kicks it off to Rhodes. And Dominique Rhodes is stood up at the 20-yard line by Jason Bell. So a 17-yard return, a minute 42 left to play in this first half. We know about the quick strike capabilities of Peyton Manning. We'll see if Tom Moore lets them loose over the final minute 42.
Well, on the last possession, actually he had Reggie Wayne up the sideline, who I think had a step or Marcus Coleman. I thought the ball was thrown, underthrown just a little bit by Peyton Manning. That's what gave way to the interception by Coleman. So they had the opportunity for big plays. He's going to have more than he's going to have to connect on it.
On first down, Indianapolis trailing 10-3, trying to secure the AFC South title and the number 3 seed. Here's Manning, steps up, guns, and broken up. Troy Walters in a matchup with Jason Simmons, a flag down. Late flag at that.
It is a very late flag, and I don't know that he was in a good position to tell if it was passing.
Holding defense number 30. 5-yard penalty from the previous spot. Automatic first down.
Well, Simmons not protesting too much. Let's watch. Number 30, Simmons working in the slot against Walters. See, there's the hand. That's the hold right there that gives him the advantage. And you know, they say the hand is quicker than the eye. Well, not for the officials, because they saw it. It's not too quick for our cameras either, because we saw it as well.
And give credit to our camera people here on this crew for capturing that Andre Johnson attempt along the sideline. Excellent camera work. Minute 35 to go. First half. On the dump off, Edgerrin James across the 30-yard line, and he picks up 7. Jay Foreman combining with Wong to make the stop. A minute 24, the clock is moving.
Well, this is that point in the game where they will go with the no huddle and that 2-minute warning, and this Colts offense has to get going. But give credit to Houston playing really good defense.
On second and 3, quick throw to Walters, and a first down for Indianapolis. Out across the 40-yard line, they pick up 8 yards. And a timeout stops the clock with a minute 3 left to go in the first half. Indy has 2 timeouts remaining.
The National Football League family is committed to supporting the courageous men and women serving in the U.S. Armed Forces in the Mideast. But the fight for freedom is not without loss. And the NFL urges you to join us and the Intrepid Fallen Heroes Fund in supporting the military families of those heroes who have sacrificed their lives in the service of our country. Please visit NFL.com/Heroes Fund and help support those families in need.
Another reminder that the Nextel Halftime Report is coming up. Jim, Dan, Dion, and Boomer, all of today's scores and highlights. And they'll be joined by Philadelphia Eagles, Brian Dawkins, Darwin Walker. That's all coming up on the Nextel Halftime Report. On first down, Indianapolis trying to get a rhythm here with a minute 3 left to go. Second quarter, trailing 10-3. Manning, pump fake, and a throw. Walters sidestepping, unable to get out of bounds. At the 45, Derek Vaughn made sure of it. 5-yard gain.
Costly mistake by Walters, because he could have gotten out of bounds, tried to throw one more move, and then the tackle was made, preventing him from getting out of bounds and stopping the clock.
And they're losing time here. Second and 5. Manning, a toss. Pollard He goes out of bounds. Did he have the first down, though?
Yes, he did.
But he lost it.
He gave it back because it was more important that he get out of bounds. He had, it's third down, so he really has two more downs. I think it was more important to try to save time there as opposed to maybe gaining three more yards.
Now a third and two. You'd like to see him do both in a perfect world. And they go to the running play. Edgerrin James comes up shy. A one-yard gain, and now the whole drive is out of whack with 27 seconds left.
And the time is ticking. They're going to call a timeout. But
Indianapolis has one timeout remaining. There will be 27 seconds to work with here in the second quarter.
Peyton Manning was talking to Marcus Pollard saying, should have went ahead and got the first down. Yeah. We could have used the timeout. Allowed you to pick up the first down.
Well, we've seen Houston take a 10-3 lead in this first half. And we've also seen Houston make some plays defensively. A stuff on Edgerrin James on fourth down. Tough running by Dominic Davis for the touchdown. And Marcus Coleman with a lunging interception for Houston. David Carr to Andre Johnson. Touchdown was nullified. The field goal from Brown. And that is your 10-3 score. Decision was made on a fourth and one. Tony Dungy says, punt it. Take no chances. Hunter Smith in, J.J. Moses, the deep man. And Moses, returnable kick from the nine. Here's Moses, and he is engulfed shy of the 20 by Anthony Floyd. 16 seconds remain in the first half. Coming up tonight on CBS, Oscar winners Meryl Streep and William Hurt, and Oscar nominee Renee Zellweger star in the network premiere of One True Thing. It's a tearjerker tonight on CBS. Now, this is not what Indianapolis envisioned coming to Houston. Peyton Manning wore his cowboy hat on the plane, got off the plane, hoping that it would give the team some good vibes for maybe a return trip a month from now to the Super Bowl.
Play's over, man.
Carr takes a knee to end this first half. The Houston Texans, they may have something to say about who wins this AFC South title. Dom Capers and the Texans with a 10-3 lead on Tony Dungy and the Indianapolis Colts. Some smart football from Houston in this first half as we go downstairs to Marcus Allen.
Thanks, Ian. Coach Dungy, you guys got a break on that touchdown call that was reversed. Offensively, you guys haven't really... You guys have moved the ball, but you haven't cashed in. What is the key? Maintaining your patience and not panicking?
Yeah, we have to be poised. We got off to a good start, had some good field position, didn't take advantage of it. Now they've got the lead. We got to be poised in the second half, play a little bit better defense, see if we can get the ball away from them.
All right, Coach, good luck second half. Thanks a lot. Back upstairs, Ian.
All right, Marcus, thank you. Thank you, Coach. The number three seed in the AFC on the line and a home game in the first round. The Colts, though, trail 10-3 at the half to Houston. The next little halftime report is coming up. You're watching the NFL on CBS.
Start your New Year's celebration early. The Minnesota Gophers go head-to-head with the Oregon Ducks. The Wells Fargo Sun Bowl, Wednesday on CBS.
Ellen Goulden has a demanding job, a brilliant father, and an unusual mother.
There's no place like home.
Now the one person she took for granted.
Mom!
Can't be ignored.
Her mother needs you.
Oscar winners Meryl Streep and William Hurt with Renee Zellweger.
How do you do this?
These are people I love.
One True Thing, CBS Tonight.
Catch all your favorite stars at the People's Choice Awards, live CBS Sunday, January 11th.
There are a lot of reasons why Ford trucks are the best in Texas, and one reason why now's the best time to buy. It's year-end clearance at your Texas Ford dealer. No one offers more number one sellers like F-150, Super Duty, and Ranger. And now through the 31st, no one offers numbers like these. Clearance financing as low as 0% for 72 months, or just announce, get $3,500 cash on F-150s. Plus, put $1,000 down and Ford Credit will match it for a total $5,500 down. Only during clearance at your Texas Ford dealer.
We took our blazing fast Roadrunner High Speed Online and cranked it up. Now it's up to 50% faster. You'll get everything you want from the internet up to twice as fast as DSL. It's one more reason that with Roadrunner High Speed Online, your world is always on.
Call today and ask how you can get Roadrunner for only $29.95 a month for 6 months.
Grand Cherokee, Liberty. You didn't try one of these, did you?
No.
Maybe.
They're tough to resist. Only a few days left in the Jeep year-end sales drive to get $500 in holiday bonus cash. Now for a limited time, get 0% financing plus $500 bonus cash or a $2,000 total cash allowance on 04 Jeep Liberty. Act now. Bonus cash ends soon.
The Emmy Award-winning 11 News Consumer Defenders, weeknights at 6.
CBS Sports presents the Nextel Halftime Report, sponsored by Nextel, nationwide walkie-talkie.
All right, friends, welcome to the Nextel Halftime Report. Jim Nance from our studios in New York. We got a full house here today. Dan, Dion, and Boomer, and a pair of Eagles stars on that defense. Talking about Brian Dawkins and Darwin Walker, fresh off their win last night. They're monitoring now that St. Louis Rams-Detroit game, hoping that perhaps Lions can pull it off, giving them the one seed. Let's take everybody through all the scores. So much hinging on these final regular season games, including Indianapolis needing a win to win the division here,
this
Dan.
This is called a lookout throw. Look out. Oh. Bradford, he gets drilled there. And then the Peyton Manning getting sacked by Jay Foreman. Getting a little pressure there, Texans, on the Colts. And then fourth and one, E.J. Edgerton James gets rejected, and they turn it over on downs. Then Mike Vanderjagt, 39-yarder, and this ties
Gary
NFL
Anderson
record with 40 in a row there. Congratulations, buddy. And then Dominic Davis, what do you do against the Colts? Game plan is running up the middle on him. He gets 12 yards for a score. Ooh, look out, Indianapolis Colts.
Colts in trouble, and how about it? You saw the field goal by Vanderjagt. He ties Gary Anderson's record. He's kicked three in this game.
O'Donnell in for Steve McNair, hitting Justin McCarron to set up a field goal right here to make the score 3-0. But Neil O'Donnell, not Steve McNair. He's trying to imitate Steve McNair, but you just can't do it. Picked up right here, Dwight Smith, fifth of the season. Tampa still not dying, trying to make something happen. Javon Curse's first interception of the season. Play action pass. You know they're not going to get the Eddie George. Broken up pass, broken up. Field goal at it right there. O'Donnell back again. Going to Steve McNair's main man, Derek Mason. 25 yards for the touch. 16-3 tights. Tampa Bay is time to lay down, baby.
And again, Gary Anderson with a third field goal right before the half. Meanwhile, the Bengals need to win, plus Baltimore lose tonight to get into the playoffs. What's the story? Cincinnati's down here at halftime.
Yeah, ball. They love Marvin Lewis, though. And look at this, Corey Dillon, 21 yards. It's good to see old number 28 running again and running with purpose. But it's Rudy Johnson right here. 5-yard touchdown run puts Bengals up 7-0. The story in this game, however, has been the ground attack by Cleveland. This is a 4th-and-1 play. Cincinnati Bengal defense holds. But how about Lee Suggs? Oh, see ya. Former Virginia Tech Hokie, the teammate of Michael Vick, takes off. And 188 yards on the ground in the first half by Cleveland. Cleveland is clinging to a 13-7 lead. And right at the end of the first half, take a look at this. 3rd and goal from the 6-yard line. John Kitnick, make it. Do something. Get rid of the ball. Throw it. You cannot do that.
How about that?
Half ends. Just throw it. What are you thinking about? Throw it away. Do something.
Yeah, show a little passion.
Hootay, hootay, hootay. Hootay.
I got the fired up.
Hootay.
How about them Kansas City Chiefs? They are the 2 seed. They got that locked up. Nothing on the line here today. Holmes with a touchdown, though. He ties the single season mark of Marshall Faulk, 26th touchdown of the season. All right, let's bring in Brian and Darwin here. What's the report here? Rams trying to win and get the 1 seed. What's the story at Detroit?
Block punt.
Marshall Faulk with a touchdown.
Penalties. Big pass is given up. I mean, you call it, they giving it up.
Still hope there, Darwin?
You know, I agree with what Brian's saying. But statistically, Detroit's right there. It's just the block punt. They got to be, watch out for the penalties and not let too many turnovers happen. And Terrence, keep bringing it, baby.
But now you know what it's like to be a Detroit Lion fan every week. block punt penalty is killing me.
All right, guys, meanwhile, the Cowboys are playing down in New Orleans, and Dante Stallworth pulls in a 76-yard pass from Aaron Brooks for the 10-7 lead there. And here are the Jets, and Ricky Williams with a big highlight in this game. Dolphins lead at the half.
And he runs over a guy here, gets over to Jets player Jay Feeler, 200 yards passing almost in the first half.
They're winning 20 to 10, baby.
They're on to the third quarter. Miami trying to finish the year 10 and 6, but again, we'll be left on the sidelines for the playoffs. Here's the Jags-Atlanta story.
The only reason they're still at the stadium, both teams going home because one guy, Michael Vick.
That's cool.
That is a beautiful thing. Hit the fearless price, who we've barely seen all year.
It's worth the price of the ticket.
That's right.
Where has he been?
Fearless?
No, Michael Vick.
Chilling.
Hey, he's Darwin's old teammate of Tennessee. We got a doubleheader day here. Denver and Green Bay, most of you will see that. Oakland, San Diego out on the West Coast. And the NFL on CBS will continue second half coming up in just a moment.
CBS Sports presents the Nextel Halftime Report, sponsored by Nextel, nationwide walkie-talkie.
Monday, it's time for the kids to go to work.
Doing what?
Would it kill you to win Wimbledon?
Still standing at a special time. Then it's a yes-dear road trip with the works.
Sonic, Logan, stop it. Oh, who am I kidding? Can't discipline my kids in a giant hot dog.
Next, will Ray take marriage advice from his newlywed brother?
You are an idiot wrapped in a moron.
And Charlie Sheen stars in TV's most-watched new comedy.
These clothes look stupid.
Jake, I'm right on the edge. Don't push me.
It all happens CBS Monday, and Julia Roberts is on The Late Show.
Go behind the scenes with Rich Eisen, only on the NFL Network.
A diamond ring means one thing. The gig is up, baby. Bye-bye, bachelorhood. It's a long talk with Jean-Pierre about princess cuts and tapered baguettes. But that was before the awakening, before the playoffs. Now a diamond ring is the reason we're here. Because of a diamond ring, everyone knows how to pronounce Favre. It's the outlaw Josie Wales riding into town willing to right the wrongs of seasons past. The playoffs made diamonds a guy's best friend and turned a diamond ring into a diamond ring.
Earlier on the NFL Today.
We would love to have it at the house, but I don't think nobody's complaining about going up there playing in the cozy dome in St. Louis if we had to do that.
They really say you can't win the big game.
Right.
And that has to be frustrating.
Yeah, I mean, that's something I certainly want to change.
Keep Peyton Manning watching the game instead of playing in the game. That's how you beat the
everybody don't have a run.
I think when the kickoff happens at 3:15, he'll be out there trying to win a football game like he does every week.
The NFL Today, the pregame show you can't afford to miss. CBS Sports presents the Nextel Halftime Report, sponsored by Nextel, nationwide walkie-talkie.
Halftime here in Houston, the Texans surprising the Colts. It's 10-3 at the break.
From all of us at CSI Miami.
Happy holidays!
It's Mitsubishi's Texas Size Savings Event. Get Texas Size deals on every Mitsubishi, like the rugged Montero Sport, or the nicely equipped Outlander starts under $16,100 after rebate. For even bigger savings, see your local Mitsubishi retailer for added factory-to-dealer cash that'll lower the price so much we can't even advertise it. And every Mitsubishi comes with a Texas Size warranty to boot. It's Mitsubishi's Texas Size Savings Event, and it ends soon. Only at your Houston Mitsubishi retailer.
When you get a GMC Yukon, you get much more than you expect. You get more horsepower and more agility than any other full-size SUV. And if you hurry into your GMC dealer today, you'll also get more to choose from. Now get $6,500 cash back on an incredible selection of 2003 Yukon XLs, or get 0% APR for 72 months for qualified buyers. Upgrade to professional grade. See your Houston area Pontiac GMC dealers today.
Seems some street punk.
Turned up dead.
Oh, no. Everybody thinks you did it.
They've just made him a marked man.
They set me up. I want his head in Dojo's bowl by midnight.
But you can't touch what you can't catch. Torque.
is why I hate four wheels.
Rated PG-13. Starts January 16th.
Yep, 32 seating configuration. I'll take it.
Act now. During the Chrysler year-end sales drive, get 0% financing plus $500 holiday bonus cash or a $2,500 total cash allowance on the 2004 PT Cruiser. Hurry in. Your chance to get holiday bonus cash ends soon.
35 days.
It's the Super Bowl
on Channel 11.
Potential upset in the making here at Reliance Stadium. 10-3 Texans on top of the Colts. We welcome you back. Ian Eagle along with Solomon Wilcots. Obviously, Indianapolis, huge game for them considering what's down the road. Postseason, they're going either way, either as a 3 seed, maybe a 5 seed, maybe a 6 seed. Do you buy into the theory that you've got to be playing well in December for it to carry over?
I think it holds true because the National Football League is really about momentum. And Bill Parcells, he talks about the playoffs as being a tournament. Right. When you go into a tournament, you better be ready to play. And it's clear that the Indianapolis Colts are not playing as well right now as they had been earlier in the year. They want to feel better about themselves, according to Tony Dungy, as they head into the postseason.
Now, this is the wrong time for a slump for Indianapolis. Humiliating loss last week on national TV against Denver, and then this first half against Houston, obviously leaving something to be desired. Moments ago, Dom Capers with our own Marcus Allen.
Coach Capers, you guys are playing very solid defense. You're not making any mistakes in offense. Is that the formula you have to take in the second half?
We know this offense is a very explosive offense. We've done a good job of not giving them a big play the first half. Our offense has been able to convert a turnover into some points. We've got to go back out this second half and do the same thing.
All right, Coach, good luck.
Thank you.
Good to see you.
So Dom Capers, second year as the head coach of this Texans team. They went 4-12 last year in their inaugural season, 5-10 right now. And some tight losses here at home. 7 home games, 6 have been decided in the closing minutes, 2 on the final play of the game. Vanderjagt, the kickoff. And the return man, Moran Norris. Along the sideline, and Norris gets some extra yardage as Ricky Williams forced him out of bounds. A 19-yard return. The leaders for Houston in that first half got off to a very slow start offensively. David Carr, 6 of 10. In the running game, though, Dominic Davis. Some electrifying plays from scrimmage. And Davis, also the leading receiver.
He's the guy that's getting it done. We told you he can catch it out of the backfield, but boy, can he run.
Double tight end set to open up this third quarter of play. And a 1st and 10 from the Texans 37. It's Davis again. The gut. Davis has just cracked 1,000 yards in his rookie season from LSU. Dominic Davis didn't start until the Texans' 6th game of the season, and now he has gone over 1,000.
It's a heck of an accomplishment by Dominic Davis. A lot of people said he was too small coming out of college, but all he's done is prove him wrong because he has helped out this offense and helped his football team tremendously.
And a 1st down for Houston at the 49 of Indianapolis. Carr to throw, fires, incomplete. Corey Bradford one-on-one with Nick Harper. And the fans wanted a penalty.
Well, I thought Bradford could have made a better adjustment on this ball. Well thrown by David Carr. It's a heater. Look at the line drive. Now he's got to come back to the ball. Settle in like what we saw with Marvin Harrison. You settle in the area where you know the ball is going to come. Then you move back to the football. Don't allow it to go behind you and allow Nick Harper to make a play.
On 2nd and 10. First minute of play in the third quarter. 3 receivers set. Davis by himself in the backfield. Carr on the throw to Davis. After the catch, Davis is tripped up. He picks up 4.5 yards. Anthony Floyd making the stop.
Well, the Texans are doing what you want from your football team. They're coming out, setting the tone here in the second half, and they've done it by getting the ball to Dominic Davis, catching the ball out of the backfield and running behind the offensive line. They're making the plays that they need to make.
Dom Capers said, hey, if we can get another turnover like we did in the first half, you know turnovers are the great equalizer, and that's why they lead on the scoreboard.
Over 100 yards of total offense for Dominic Davis.
I got you.
And a third and six now for Houston. Davis shifting in the backfield. Here's Carr. Steps up. Guns. Complete. Andre Johnson. Big gainer as they convert the third down. 18 yards. Good move by Johnson up the field.
And what a whip of an arm David Carr has. Watch this ball come out of his hand. It's a lively throw. It's accurate, right on the money as Johnson comes across the formation. Now check out Dwight Freeney. We know that he can get sacks, double-digit sacks this year, but look at him getting doubled right here by Chester Pitts and Dominic Davis. You know, this is something they haven't had to do a lot of. They haven't had to chip with the running back because Pitts has been doing such a good job blocking in one-on-one.
On first down, it's Davis and runs into a wall of white jerseys. No gain on the play. We told you about Dominic Davis going over 1,000 yards. Andre Johnson beginning to close in on 1,000 yards as well, and they would become the first rookie tandem to crack 1,000 yards in the same season in NFL history.
Is this franchise headed in the right direction?
I think so.
I mean, there you are. Charlie Casserly, the general manager of this football team, along with their head coach and then their owner, Bob McNair, Dom Capers, they're just doing such a wonderful job at building, I think, a really good foundation for a good football team.
On second down, another toss from Carr to Johnson. 11 yards and a new set of downs for the Texans to work with. They are moving the football, first possession of this second half.
And they're moving it with six offensive linemen on the field. Short of tight end, they're playing six offensive linemen, so they have the protection to get the ball out to their weapons, Johnson and Dominic Davis, but they also are able to run the ball effectively. That's why you're seeing balance on this possession.
And a first and 10 from the Colts' 16-yard line. Houston already with a 10-3 lead. Give is to Davis, trying to emerge through a hole, and Davis turns it into something. It could have been no gain. Instead, it's a 3-yard pickup. Josh Williams, the stop. Well, we talk about the Rookie of the Year candidates around the NFL. You're seeing two of them on display right now.
Yeah, Anquan Boldin will be the guy to win it, you know, setting a rookie record for receptions in a single season. But to have Dominic Davis and Andre Johnson on that board, it tells you that this franchise is doing a lot of things right when it comes to acquiring the right kind of players.
Those numbers entering action today through 15 games for those individual rookies. Second and 7. Give is to Davis. Stutter step move. And Davis breaks through. Touchdown, Texans. His second of the day.
There's the talent we were talking about. Because you can only block so many guys, whether you have five offensive linemen, six offensive linemen, like what Houston has on this play. But they get the push up front. And they're just hammering away at this Indianapolis Colts defense. But watching make people miss there on the second level. Adrees Bashir can't get him. Neither can the diving linebacker. And he waltzes right in for the touchdown to give his team a tremendous lead in this ball game and a tremendous psychological advantage over the Indianapolis Colts.
13 carries, 86 yards, 2 touchdowns for Davis. Fred Weary injured on the play, and the Houston medical staff has come out onto the field before the extra point.
You know, he's a short guy. He's just one of those sawed-off guys. You talk about him being small, but look at the leg drive. Powerful leg, but then watch the footwork. You see the stutter step and do it. He leaves a guy, Chad Brasky, in his tracks. There's another guy go diving away, and then he's able to break tackles on the second level. But his shifty ability, much like what they saw in Quentin Griffin last week. But, boy, this guy has the power to go along with those stutter step moves.
Davis told us his entire life he's been told he's too small. You're just a special teams guy. He's been hearing it forever, and it has motivated him.
That was a beautiful run by Dominic Davis.
Third time this season he has posted multiple touchdowns in the same game. And he is also inching very close to his fifth 100-yard rushing day. Weary helped off the field. Chris Brown the extra point for Houston. And the Texans send an early third quarter message to the Indianapolis Colts. It's 17-3, Houston.
Maybe this isn't the best time to say it, but I think you're really beautiful.
Well, I've always been attracted to you too, Paul.
Wait, hold on one sec, babe. Excuse me?
Want to get away? Now you can, with Southwest Airlines Internet Specials. Just $39 to $99 when you purchase by January 19th. Only at Southwest.com.
You are now free to move about the country.
Meeting's at 8. We got 5 minutes to get there.
Go around this guy. He's not even moving.
With the class-leading 250-horsepower V6 engine, the Saturn View can get you to the meeting on time. Unless you turn on the 6-speaker stereo. Get a new 2004 Saturn View with 0% APR financing for 5 years. See your retailer for details.
Mike, Sue.
Yes.
Love and honor.
Yep.
Sickness, health.
Uh-huh.
Objections?
Rings? Do you?
I do.
Do you?
I do.
Kiss?
Husband and wife. Next!
Nextel walkie-talkies get it done.
Start your New Year's celebration early. The Minnesota Gophers go head-to-head with the Oregon Ducks. The Wells Fargo Sun Bowl, Wednesday on CBS.
This telecast is copyrighted by the NFL for the private use of our audience. Any other use of this telecast or of any pictures, descriptions, or accounts of the game without the NFL's consent is prohibited.
A fourth-round pick out of LSU. Not expected to be a difference maker, but Dominic Davis is making a difference here today. His second touchdown run against the playoff-bound Indianapolis Colts. And now Tom Moore and Peyton Manning huddle up. Their offense will touch it for the first time in this third quarter.
And this is where Peyton has to be careful, because he told us, I feel like I have to go out and make more plays. And with the scoreboard 17-3, well, yeah, he's going to have to make a play, but still has to be careful with the football.
Dominique Rhodes after the kick by Brown. And Rhodes has nowhere to go once he hit the 26. Jason Simmons makes the special teams play. We'll come back. More third quarter action in a moment.
With a 140-horsepower engine and responsive handling, we put the fun back into the compact car, the Saturn Ion. Finance a new 2004 Saturn Ion 1 with air conditioning and CD player for $179 a month. See your retailer for details.
Consider all the ways you help protect yourself. And if you've had a heart attack, ask your doctor if you're doing enough to help protect your heart. The Heart Protection Study by Oxford University researched Zocor. Zocor, along with diet, is the only cholesterol medication proven to significantly reduce the risk of heart attack and stroke in people with heart disease, regardless of cholesterol level. Zocor is a prescription medicine and is not for everyone, including women who are nursing, pregnant, or may become pregnant, or people with liver problems. Your doctor may do blood tests to check for liver problems. Because serious side effects can result, tell your doctor about any muscle pain or weakness you experience and about any medicines you are taking. If you've had a heart attack, get information about the Heart Protection Study and Zocor and ask your doctor how Zocor can help protect you. It's your future. Be there.
The NFL on CBS is sponsored by Southwest Airlines. Friendly nonstop service all across the country. Southwest Airlines, a symbol of freedom. Wachovia Securities. Together we can achieve uncommon results. And by Saturn, makers of the highly adaptable View, stylish midsize L300, and the fun-to-drive Ion.
Back in Houston, let's check in with a man that knows a little bit something about the running game, Marcus Allen.
Thanks, Ian. This is the one aspect of the game that I love, the running game, because it is the one aspect that makes your opponent throw up the white flag. It destroys who you are. It destroys your will. That's what the running game does. And Dominic Davis at this point, guys, he's just being intuitive. He's just being instinctive. He's doing his thing, guys.
On first down, Manning hooks up with Edgerrin James for a 9-yard gain. And you're right. It can really knock your spirits down defensively when you cannot stop the run, lining up man for man against the other team.
And Marcus has made an excellent point. Look at the defensive players for the Indianapolis Colts, and they are, in their eyes, I see bewilderment, and they're not thinking that this could have happened. It happened last week. Last week was a fluke. Well, guess what, guys? It's happening again, playing the Houston Texans.
Colts have had more opportunities today compared to last week as James carries for three and a first down for Indianapolis. Corey Sears